There are likely many, many, many different reasons for the varied ways people respond to this virus, but right now, everything still remains speculation. In general, differences in immune function between otherwise healthy individuals may be attributed to many factors, which we will discuss, including genetics, previous exposure to pathogens, sleep, microbiome composition, exercise, nutrition, gender, and biological age. A large part of the variation in immune function between individuals, particularly with respect to adaptive immunity, has been determined to be from non-heritable factors, which we are about to dive into. But genetics does account for some of this variation. The severity of a viral infection depends on the pathogenicity of the virus, as well as the health status and genetic makeup of the host. Polymorphic regions, referred to as single nucleotide polymorphisms, or SNPs for short, in various genes may affect the disease outcome of an infected individual. There are several large collaborative efforts underway to share and analyze genetic data to try and understand the links between human genetic variation and COVID-19 disease and severity. The largest one is called the COVID-19 Host Genetic Initiative. Several SNPs have previously been identified to affect immune responses to the SARS-CoV-1 virus, and several studies have already identified several possible SNPs that may potentially impact susceptibility to COVID-19, although these remain to be tested in large genomic studies and clinical trials. There are some SNPs that affect general viral entry into the host cell, for example, ACE2, the host cell receptor for SARS-CoV-2. TMPRSS2, a protease that cleaves the spike protein, allowing SARS-CoV-2 to enter the cell. IFITM3, a protein that interrupts the fusion between a virus and the cell membrane, associated with the severity of influenza. There are also a variety of SNPs that generally affect viral replication. There are also SNPs that affect the host immune response, ranging from cytokine production to viral-induced inflammation. And there are SNPs that affect acute respiratory distress syndrome. There are also several SNPs that affect vitamin D levels. Genetically low plasma vitamin D levels are associated with a higher mortality from respiratory infections. And three different SNPs in the vitamin D receptor are all associated with a higher risk of respiratory tract infections in both adults and children. Vitamin D is a very important regulator of immune function and plays a particularly important role in respiratory tract infections. If you have used some consumer genetic testing services like 23andMe and Ancestry DNA, and you want to learn more about these SNPs, we put together a free viral report that you can find at foundmyfitness.com/genetics.